algorithm, the output of the randomized algorithm depends upon the random decision taken by the randomizer. Here, first character, what is the first character? The output of the randomized algorithm depends on the random decision taken by the randomizer. Whatever his decision that takes the randomizer, that we have produced the output of the randomized algorithm. So then we have produced the output of random algorithm. So because of the reason, output of the randomizer depends upon the randomized decision or random decision taken by the randomized algorithm. Okay, we have to take in the decision that takes the randomizer. Second output based on the probability. Second one you have to take into the probability. You have to probability, you have to see in the sample example. Suppose we have to toast a or a flip a coin. What is the probability of the getting of the head? And what is the probability of the getting of the time? So now output is getting based on the probability. In how much probability we have to get of the output and how much probability we have to getting the output of the head. Hence we have to say that output is based upon the probability. Third one we have to seeing that negligence errors that occurs in a algorithm. Simply we have to avoid the what are the errors occurs in a randomized algorithm. So we have to three or a characteristics of the randomized algorithm. What are the three characteristics of the randomized algorithm? We have to output is based on the random decision, and we have to take into probability decision, and we have to somehow to now to come to errors it in a long time. That errors we have to come that to avoid that errors, and in a randomized algorithm. These are the characteristics of the randomized algorithm. Next we have to see the generating, how to generating the random number. Next we have to see the how to generating of the random number. A random number is generated by using the random number generator. A randomizer produce a random number so that we can generate by the random number generator. English in the acronym, a randomizer produce a random number so that generated by the random number generator or randomizer. There are two types of the random number generator. First one is true random number. Second one is pseudocode random number. In two ways to generating the number. First one, true random number. Second one, pseudo random number. In true random number is randomly generating by using the radioactivity or flip coins and radioactivation. So because this one a true random number generator, this is a one way of the generating of the true random number. Second one we have to see, whatever true random number is generated, that should not be occurs again next. Okay, sorry, it's generating the one random number, again we have to not generating the another number. In random number is generating only once. In same random number is not generating in a future. That is a described by true random number. A true random number cannot be creating only once. The same of the random number cannot be occur again, because the true random number is generating by using the radioactivity, flip the coins and radiation. This are a true random number. Next we have to see in the second generation or generating of random number, pseudo code random number. These are creating again. This is generating by the some software application. Here pseudo code generation number is generating by the some software application. We have to generating the pseudo code number can be creating again. It's be formula is a unknown. Manam malli recreate chesukovalante we have to know the formula of the what is the formula here is using. That formula is in now we have to use to generate the pseudo code random number. If a formula is a noun, then we have to recreate the pseudo code random number. But in case of true random number, if it is not possible to recreate the random number, in second one he have to sufficiently for most of the application. We have to seeing in a properties. First one is we have to most of the applications we have to seeing in a properties in a pseudo code random number. This pseudo code random number is in most of the application because it is a efficiency. Pseudo code random number is a deterministic in all the cases. Is always produce the output for a given input. Third one is uniformly and fourth one is independent. Whatever the input to generate, we have to seeing in a third one and a fourth one. Whatever the input that generating the ones in the using of the RAM pseudo code random number, and second time the same of the pseudo code random number cannot generating, so it is a independent. It is a formula known as we have to recreate the same random number. It is a formula is in not known. That random number is a different that are generating by using the pseudo code random number again and again. So it is independently. These are a properties of the pseudo code random number. This is a description of the pseudo code random number. What is a pseudo code random number? It is a generating for a any or a some software application. In software application we have to generating the we have to know the formula, then we have to recreating the number. Next we have to seeing the what are the principles of the random number generation. So man random number generation cheyalante asli enti, what are the principles of the random memorized algorithm? First one is random tiles. Second one is check whether a given input x has the property of y. Third one is primary test. Here primary test means to check the whether given number is prime or not. That is the one of the principles of the primary. these are the principles of the randomized algorithm. There are three principles of the randomized algorithm. Next we have to see in the what are the next principles means. First one is to check the given number is primarized, means to check the given number is prime or not. Next we have to randomly pick the number, pick the numbers, that is random type. Other third one is check whether a given x has the proper y or not. We have to take in the random, that random is having some property, that is correct or not, to checking that one the principles of the randomized algorithm. Next we have to see the two algorithms in randomized, Lassa Venus algorithms, Montano Cardano algorithms. We have two types of algorithm. We have to see in the example what is the definition. We starting with the Las Vegas. We have to starting with the Las Vegas. In this algorithm, always produce a correct output. Always produce the correct output for the some inputs. It is a probability foster algorithm. It has a probability foster algorithm in case of the second algorithm. These algorithms is produced by the mostly of the probability correct output. Here we have to running time, we have to taking to randomly. For some inputs of the algorithm is a taking to here, you have to taking the some inputs of the algorithm is a run again and again. We have to get the different outputs of the Montano Cardano algorithm. So these algorithms produce a mostly. So this algorithm is produce mostly of the probability and correctly input. Sorry, Amma, you have to output. You have to mostly and the probability correct of the output. In this algorithms produce a correct output of the seven some input and the last figures algorithms have a randomized algorithms depends upon the randomizer. We have to seeing in a example randomized Kreutzer. Here we have to taking to some running time complexity, how to taking to the polynomial equations, and you have to taking next, we have to see the next slide. Montano Cardano algorithm is provides the Montano algorithm is provides the mostly and a probability correct output. It is a nothing but we have to seeing the two examples in a last, we have to seeing in a two examples, randomized min-cut algorithm and a primarily test. It is nothing but we have to checking the whether given number is prime or not. We have to how to check that number. We have to check the random number, that number is prime or not. In Montano Cardano algorithm is polynomial time algorithm because the algorithm is running time is a completely within a polynomial time, hence we have to say that that algorithm is running time within a polynomial time. So we have to difference between of the both algorithms. have to first we have to see here correct, here it is produce the correct output, and a Monte Carlo algorithm produce the most probability and correct output. In case of Las Vegas algorithm, the probability is given algorithm or a faster the algorithm. Then to compare is the second algorithm, that algorithm is this or slowly algorithm. This is a faster algorithm, this is a slowly produce the algorithm. Here time complexity is using to, sorry, here time complexity have to use into polynomial, and it is example of the quicksort example. We have to seeing the example of the priming test or a randomized mini-cut algorithm. These are two examples we have to seeing to the cardinal algorithm. What are the what is the advantages of the random algorithm, disadvantages of the random algorithm. First we have to see the advantages of the random algorithm, randomized algorithm. First we have to simplicity means randomized algorithms are simple in nature. It is a pseudocode random number generator, so it is the simplest. We have to see the second advantage is very efficiency. When comparison to traditional algorithm or a deterministic algorithm, when deterministic algorithm is input always fixed, but in a randomized algorithm there is no fixed input, so it is a very efficient. Deterministic algorithm can take the produce of more time to produce the output, it takes the more time. But in case of the randomized algorithm, can takes only less time to produce the output. It is a one advantages of the randomized algorithm. Second, third one is to see computing complexity is better than the deterministic algorithm. We have to see that third one algorithm advantage is, in case the deterministic algorithm is, there is a fix of some, we have to fixing the path from input to output. There is a largest path connect input to output. So we have to take in the deterministic algorithm, we have to take in the largest time to produce the output. So in case of the deterministic algorithm. But in case of the randomized algorithm, there is no fixed path. So it can be very less time to produce the output by using the randomized input of the randomized algorithm. What is the, how to, it is a complexity is better to, it is a better to the deterministic algorithm. These are advantages of the randomized algorithm. Next we have to seeing the disadvantages of the randomized algorithm. First we have to quality, second one is hardware failure, third one is reliability in any issues. First we want to see to quality. Here quality of the randomized algorithm depends upon the random. Here quality and then will depend on the random. So that is random number generator based on the randomized or random number generator. We have to generate output of the random algorithm, randomized algorithm. So here quality depends upon the random number generator. It is a part of the algorithm. So it is a quality is a last in a randomized algorithm. Second one is reliability in an issues. Here reliability issues nothing but some algorithms may lack of certain guarantee solution. We have to loss of the some guarantee solution. We wear a guarantee say that we will get a correct solution in a randomized algorithm. That is, algorithm may lack of certain guaranteed solutions. We can say that may or may guarantee not correct the solution for a given algorithm by using the deterministic algorithm. We can guarantee say that get correct to given the problem. Here we can guarantee say that to get the correct given problem, guarantee 100% we have to get the correct solution, but in the case of the determination algorithm, in the case of determination algorithm is taking the large process, we have to take in the large time, but it's to get the correct output. In randomized algorithm is it difficult to get the correct solution, but we have to take the small amount of the time to compare the to get the output of the correctly. So it is a difficult, so it is a disadvantages of the issue. Reliability in advent in issues. In deterministic have a it is 100% correct, you have to take. In randomized algorithms you have to take into randomly pick, so it is a lack of the guarantee of the output, so it is a reliability. Next we have to take into the next one is the hardware failure. Hardware failure means here in the case of randomized algorithm we have to use the random number generator. That is hardware part, something hardware may be failed. We are getting the output of the random algorithm. We are not getting hardware anedi edana fail aithe, we are not getting the any random number. So it is a disadvantages of the randomized algorithm. Reliability, hardware failure, quality. These are the disadvantages of the randomness algorithm. We have to see in the examples of the algorithm. So then we have to go to that example. We have to any doubts, we have to any problem, please will be clear it.